Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to St. Thomas More Newman Center. Great to see all of you here today. We are a ministry of the Paulus Fathers. Always wonderful to say that. If you are using a missalette, those were located in the north entrance as you came in. Today's readings can be found beginning on page 414. Page 414. Today we are celebrating the 15th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Our presider this morning is Father Eric Andrews, who is the president of the Paulus Fathers. That's how important we are. So just keep that in mind. Let's take a moment and rise and greet those around us before we begin. Let's return to an atmosphere of quiet and reflection as we prepare to begin this celebration. Thank you.
Standing face to face, here in our hearts, here in our of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Greetings and welcome everyone on this wet and rainy 15th Sunday of Ordinary Time, if we haven't met before. My name is Father Eric Andrews. I'm the president of the Paulus Fathers. My first time back in Columbus at the Newman Center since before COVID, almost 2 years. It's great to see all of you this day. Blessings to you. It's great to see your smiling faces. Everyone looks younger from last time I was here. Can you tell I'm here for a specific purpose? We are here for a specific purpose, and that is for the mission of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. As Father Steve Bell would say, can I get an amen to that?
Amen.
So as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred Eucharist this day, let us call to mind God's graciousness in our life. Let us recall all of our losses and all of our blessings, but most of all, the blessing of God's life within us, which frees us from sin and death. So let us take a moment and call to mind our sins, aware of a God who loves us deeply. Lord Jesus, you are the way and the truth and the life. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you heal us of our sins and of our infirmity. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you always intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring all of us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen. Who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go, prophesy to my people, Israel.'" The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundations of the world, to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of God's grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him, we have redemption by his blood, the forgiveness of transgressions in accordance with the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us. In all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will in accord with his favor that he set forth in him as a plan for the fullness of all time. To sum up all things in Christ, in heaven, and on earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, again, it's great to be with you all. If you entered late and wondered who I am not a new priest here at the Newman Center. I'm an old face, Father Eric Andrews, president of the Paulus Fathers. According to my app, I have only 318 days left in my presidency. Praise the Lord. But I am here on a missionary journey of which I hope that I can embark and invite all of you to be on with me. I am here today to talk to you about a very extraordinary moment and effort in the Paulus Fathers
called Hope for the Future. It is the Paulist comprehensive campaign. And while you think this may be a talk about money, and I know you do, this is really a talk about mission. You know, when I do these, and when I was originally thinking about this, first time back here after COVID, a lot of people are trying to pull their lives together, lots to think about, the world is kind of changed and different, et cetera, et cetera. I said, is it time to have a talk about this sort of campaign? And I also thought, well, maybe I can just appease people who said, I haven't been back in the church, I've been watching live stream or whatever for all of these months now. The first time I come back to the Newman Center, they're talking about money. And I was going to offer someone who was that upset about it a $5 gift card to go to the Starbucks in the rain right now and wait it out. However, I have been convicted by the gospel and the readings this morning, which are all about speaking the words of the gospel and truth to people who don't want to hear it. Moreover, though, in order for any missionary to do what he or she has been called to do by the Lord, one has to know one very essential thing that was said in that letter of Paul to the Ephesians. You need to know that you have been chosen by God, loved by God so much that you are his adopted children. Did you hear that? You've been blessed with every spiritual blessing in the heavens. That's a ton of blessing you already have through your baptism, through your confirmation, through your active participation in the Eucharist. You are overflowing with grace. And what does that look like? That means a free gift. So I'm going to give this Starbucks card randomly as a free gift, as a sign of what it means to be a baptized Christian, a free gift. That's what grace is. You didn't earn it. I just gave it to you, just like that. It's only $5. You can't even buy a sandwich with that at the Starbucks. But it's the idea. It's the idea of it. It's free. And once you know that you've received a gift like that, maybe bigger than the Starbucks card, although when you get a free gift to the church, it means a lot. And this could be, a parenthesis, a way in which, you know, people come back to church, they know they get a free toaster like at the bank and things. We call it Palm Sunday, but we are called to be missionaries. It is our life's work as baptized. We need to take that overflowing of grace that we have received, that we just heard about, and give it away to someone else. We need to share it. And you all at this community, whether you're a student, whether you've been here since 1956 when we first got here, that's not me. You have been joined with us Paulists in that mission of sharing the good news. And also, in a deeper way, for some of you as Paulist associates and as longtime members of this community, you have shared in the Paulist mission in very deep ways. The Paulist mission is very simple. It's to share the grace and the wonderful nature of our church to everyone, to engage culture, to engage people of in academic situations, to be able to bridge faith, culture, science, whatever it is, to imagine a church bigger than we can even imagine. We are called to welcome and include, that every soul is important to us and we want to be connected. Isaac Hecker imagined a community that would make America Catholic. What a huge vision. And Isaac Hecker had that great enthusiasm as a missionary to imagine that everyone would want to believe as he did. He shot for the stars in the heavens, and he brought many to the church. Not the United States, but he certainly, by having those type of vision and that type of insight, pulls one forward to go beyond what you thought was possible. We are here today to talk more about mission and about the Paulus mission, a mission that I know that you have appreciated, you have benefited with, that you have informed us by your sharing of faith. I'm here today to ask you to keep that mission going here at the Newman Center and across the United States and in Rome and in all of North America. I'm inviting you to recommit, to get on the board again, to co-mission with us in this work of making America Catholic in its own kind of way, to shoot for the stars. And to do that, we are having an extraordinary campaign. Last time we did this was back in 2008 when we were 150 years old. We are, if you didn't know, the original and first community of American Catholic priests, missionaries to our own country. We're the first community to do that. And we want to continue that great work. And so we've embarked on this campaign. And what am I asking you to help us with this day? I'm asking you to help us to keep the mission going in these four ways. First of all, we need to build, and are building, and have started the foundation work on, a new building in Washington that can form the next generation of Paulus priests. A house of mission and studies, a house for our novices. You met Zach Turner back during Lent. You met Ben Chisholm the year before. A home for them so that they can get to Catholic University up the street and continue their studies for the priesthood. But the house is bigger than that. It's also a place of evangelization. Hopefully we will have a state-of-the-art media facility that we know from COVID we need to have to evangelize and spread the word across the U.S. It'll be a place where our national offices for ecumenism and interfaith dialogue, our Office of Reconciliation that invites Catholics to come back to the faith, it'll be also in that building as well. So the big part of this campaign is doing that, building a building which we haven't built anything in the Paulus Fathers since the 1950s. This is the first time we're investing in this effort so that we might not only attract people to come into the Paulus priesthood, but to come here and to serve you and continue to serve you. It is the intention of the Paulus Fathers to never leave Columbus, Ohio, if we could ever help it. So please know that investing in this mission is investing in this community and in yourselves. The second part is we have to run the building. Tuition costs at Catholic University are not cheap. You'd think they'd give it away so you'd have more priests. They do not. So we need, you know, and in the Diocese of Columbus, there are campaigns for the seminarians here as well that you give to, I hope, when called to. But this is an opportunity to support the priests who will serve you. Second thing is the National Office of Retired Religious, there is such a thing in the Bishops' Conference, every year tells us how we're doing in terms of taking care of our seniors. They tell us year after year, and this year we just received another almost $100,000 grant from them, meaning that we are grossly underfunded for the needs of our retired Paulus Fathers. Not Father Vinny at 90, he's still going, but in a sense, there are other Paulus who are not able to continue to minister as robustly as Father Vinny does where he is right now. We need to be able to take care of those Paulus Fathers who are seniors who need your help, or need our help, yours, okay. So people like Father Jack Collins, people like Father Joe Scott, a number of other Paulus who have served here over the years, this campaign will help make sure that they will be taken care of in their senior years. Thank you, if you ever take up that religious retirement collection here, thank you for all your support. Father Vinny doesn't cost much. He's very frugal. But I will tell you this, when Father Joe Ciccone retires, that's going to be expensive. So please help. Just thinking ahead. Third thing. Many of our senior fathers live in our mother house in New York City at 59th Street and 9th Avenue, a building that's as old as Vinny. It's 90 years old. aging not as well as Vinny is aging. That and many other Paulus properties need to be upgraded. So part of this campaign is to take care of those capital needs. And finally, a number of our ministries have really been socked by COVID-19. Particularly our mission in Rome to the American pilgrims and those tourists and expats who live in Rome, where Father Joe currently is working right now. He sends his love, he's doing great. But they have not had the benefit of the pilgrims coming through St. Patrick's in Rome. And so they're really experiencing some downturn in supporting that ministry. This campaign will take care of that, as well as look after ministries like the Paulus Press. We do not have a Paulist who is equipped to follow Father Mark David to be its publisher and president. Running a major publishing house requires the know-how and the professionalism, and we need the resources to hire lay people to do that work. So this campaign helps us to be able to do that. So, hope for the future. And joining and missioning with us in this campaign, God willing, we will continue to do the wonderful things that Paulus do. Reach out through the media, reach out here in campuses and parishes and downtown centers to continue to be good news, a source of welcome and grace to all who seek the Lord. Now, this week or sooner or later, you'll see an envelope like this in the mail if you are a registered member of the Newman Center. Do not throw it out. This is not junk mail, my friends. This is a missionary invitation from the Lord himself through me, his chosen vessel at this moment, asking you to consider being a part of this effort. Now, as you heard in that gospel reading, being a missionary means going without and leaving room and leaving things behind. When you are called by the Lord to mission, there is always a challenge and there's always a stretch. Can you imagine going out on mission without your luggage? Well, this invitation will invite you to make perhaps a sacrificial gift towards this campaign. It won't be, can you give us $20? It's going to be something that might make you say, wow, Father Eric, Dios mío, what are you thinking? That's like, wow, that's a lot to ask. But we are asked to reflect on how much has been given, how much the Lord has blessed us with, and our call to give back as best we can. Now, I know right now in the midst of COVID, a lot of people are struggling. Folks are out of work still. Things aren't back together again. And so if you're not able to support, or maybe you're a student and don't have the resources, ask you to pray for us, for our people in formation, that there may be more vocations to the Paulus Fathers. I appreciate your prayers for our mission and our men, our seniors, and everybody. That would be awesome. But if you can make a gift, whether it's over a 3-year period or longer, whether you decide, well, maybe I can leave something in my will when all's said and done, or maybe I know a foundation in the Columbus area who might be able to make a grant to the Paulus for the needs of this campaign, I ask you all to think about how you might be able to be a part of this awesome endeavor. One that hopefully will bring us not only take care of the needs of the present, but situate us well for the needs of the church in the future. I want to thank Father Ed. I want to thank our co-chairs, Deb and Greg Stipe. Wave. They'll answer questions. And there's other people who are on the missionary team who are going to go way out of their way as Americans at this point and call people to ask them to join them in this missionary effort. So who's on the volunteer team who graciously have given time to help out on this effort? If you dare to stand up as missionaries, we'd like to see who you are. If you, come on, just stand up. Thank you. I want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Good luck. Remember the gospel. If you get a hang up or someone says they're not going to give anything to the Paulus Fathers, just shake it off. Shake off the dust off the bottom of your... Look at those holes. I need new shoes. Shake it off and move on.
Just like when you're trying to share your faith with someone that doesn't have a reception, focus on the possibilities. Don't focus on the negative. Keep going forward. We are in a new place as church. We're in a new place as country. After COVID, there are new opportunities for us to share the faith in new ways, or through the wisdom that we have hard won, whether it's here, and my condolences goes to this community, the passing of Lois and PJ Connor. I thank you for the way you have supported us Paulists. When Father Rich Colgan, our novice director, died, thank you for your prayers. Personally, those who know my mom, I appreciate your prayers. We are all in this together, in this new world where we have learned so much through such difficult times. We are positioned now because we're here because we know that God gets us through it all. Trust in that blessing. Again, as St. Paul said, the overflowing of heavenly blessings that sustain us. And if you're feeling low as a missionary, that you ain't got it in you, remember this little admonition that'll help you on a rainy day like this. I'm gonna have the words in front of me because you know I blow the lyrics. Just say hello to a brand new world, a world right outside your door. Say hello to a singing bird like no bird you heard before. It's all there, go and have your share. Life is God's great big show, so reintroduce yourself to life. Say hello, amen. That was about mission, not money. Well, in faith then, in trust, let us together profess the faith we share. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As the children of God, we bring our needs and the needs of the whole world before the Lord with faith and hope.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Pope Francis and leaders of the church that they always proclaim to the good news to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all civic leaders around the world, that they always seek peace and charity for all peoples. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the success of the Hope for the Future Paulist campaign and a continued outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon the Paulist mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to poverty, suffering, and violence in our nation and world, and for an increase in charity and service to alleviate these pains. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to this pandemic, that the health care needs of all may be met. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all students, faculty, and staff at OSU and area colleges, that they continue to be led by the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are sick and suffering, and for all who care for them, that they may know the loving comfort of God in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died, that all may be comforted by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the intentions in the silence of our hearts. And for all the prayers in our book of intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all hopefulness, in Jesus you have chosen us to be your children. Hear our prayers that we might joyfully give our lives to you and to proclaiming the coming of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good, good of all of his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son and confirm us in the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests, deacons, and religious, and with your entire people, grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching and divine mercy, we dare to say. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. It's great to be with you all again. Thanks so much for your time. Out in the lobby, you'll see a thermometer with the goal of the campaign here at St. Thomas More Newman Center. Do not be afraid, but have trust and hope. If you make your goal, the Godfather here will give back to the local community $50,000. So please have at it. If I promised Father Ed, if you doubled your goal, I'll double that as well. So that's a little bit more. Shoot for the stars. I want to thank you all for the wonderful music this morning. As always, Eric, thank you so much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God descend upon you and remain with you always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and live the gospel with your lives. Thanks be to God.